Breaking news about Melania. We stand by her. Melania Trump doesn't have a personal staff as big as Michelle Obama's was, which was an intentional decision she made to cut back on unnecessary spending. Operating with a team of professionals who each have an important purpose, our compassionate First Lady shows sincere gratitude for each person who helps her, recognizing that it's a privilege. So when she saw how they were treated recently, Melania responded in a surprising way out of protection for the people who help her do her job. Melania doesn't speak often unless she has something meaningful or important to say. She saves her words for when they matter most, especially since the liberal media is waiting with bated breath for a chance to twist anything she says or does. Today she said something that won't soon be forgotten, especially by her entire flight crew who her remarks were directed at. While Melania is traveling around the globe on her first overseas trip as First Lady, she's on Air Force One just about daily, going from one location to the next. It's a lot of travel and flight time, which she's become somewhat used to as she flies frequently while living in New York, but having First Lady duties in Washington, D.C., with this much time in the sky and need to rely on her flight crew she and her staff are dependent on, the team has gotten to know the personable First Lady, and they aren't just any flight crew. Melania and her staff are transported by the U.S. Army 1st 214th Aviation Regiment, who have always shown the First Lady and her staff the utmost respect in doing this important job. This is something that hasn't gone unnoticed by Melania, who likes others to know how much they are appreciated, rather than just taking advantage of it the opportunities afforded her like her predecessor seemed to do. Even though she's overseas right now, Melania hasn't forgotten about her awesome army men who she publicly thanked today on Twitter going into this Memorial Day weekend. Like her husband, our First Lady has a love and respect for our military. Thank you to the AU's Army 1st 214th Aviation Regiment for getting me and my staff to RMTGS safely. #G7#Catania#Italy, Melania tweeted from her official Twitter account today. She didn't have to say a word, and perhaps nobody would have expected her to, but the fact that she remembered them and made a point to thank them for their service to she and her staff, speaks volumes as to the incredible First Lady we have in the White House. The gesture wasn't just well received by the American public, who appreciated her thoughtfulness to our military. Other servicemen and women saw her social media message and responded with gratitude. Thank you at FLOTUS for representing the USA and making our armed forces proud. #Memorial Day, one reader replied. Inevitably, the liberals came out in the comments too, as they always do as soon as FLOTUS posts anything, since they are waiting for it. One took the opportunity of seeing the photo of Melania with the Army flight crew to ask about her husband's service in an accusatory way, claiming he dodged the draft. A wise citizen responded to it, effectively putting this role in their place. Not serving doesn't mean you're a draft dodger. He registered. Lots of guys did and got deferments. Some actually left the country, the Twitter user wrote. What's truly remarkable is that Melania is an immigrant and has more respect for our armed forces and genuine love for our country than ungrateful degenerates who were born here and seem to hate it. Our First Lady is proof that immigrants who come to America the right way are proud citizens who have a deep appreciation for what makes America great, and that starts with our military. It wasn't often or ever that the Obamas showed this kind of gratitude for anyone who flew them around safely. In fact, our former president couldn't even bring himself to salute soldiers standing outside Air Force One or Marine One to welcome him. We've come a long way in the White House in a short time, with the Trumps there now who truly love this country and respect its citizens.